In the following, we will look at data stream management systems and also the continuous query language CQL. So here we consider also a data stream model. Of course, the stream S is a multiset of elements as before. So we have tuples which are the tuple itself, and we have timestamp associated with the tuple. Here we assume we have a schema like in a database system, so they can be attributes, just that now we have also timestamps and that the data items, the tuples, are streaming into our system. For instance, we have here a relation, a streaming relation, if you want to say it like this. We have here the vehicle ID, speed, then the position coordinate, the direction, and the highway. This little example, which was also a benchmark proposed to evaluate such data stream systems. And here the aim is, in this application, to do congestion warnings, congestion predictions, estimations of travel time, and so on. Also, as we have seen earlier, we can have environmental monitoring applications. Here we have a relation consisting of humidity, solar radiation, and so on. And of course, even if it's not written here explicitly, we always assume we have also a timestamp here. Now, I mentioned earlier already that in contrast to ad hoc queries, which are usually executed only once in relational database systems, here we talk about continuous queries, which are registered to the system and in principle run forever. For instance, a query could be like this. You want to stay updated to avalanche risk, not just check once how risky it is before you go skiing, but on the way to the skiing resort, you want to always be updated on that risk. And even if you're skiing, you want to get informed. So this is like a continuous query, also called standing query or subscription. Subscription is often used in the publish-subscribe context. And there are plenty of applications, for instance, monitoring the average temperature outside or in your CPU and so on. Or you want to select all orders of the stock Apple with quantity larger than 100 if you're monitoring the stock market, for instance. And you want to do this continuously, not only one time. So what and how can we compute database style queries, because we know SQL very well, right? So how can we now compute, let's say, the average of a data stream, which is possibly infinite? So we cannot really block everything, write it to disk, and then import it to a database and then execute our SQL queries. This doesn't work. So we cannot store the data streams and then process the queries offline. So we have to somehow find a way to express how we can aggregate or how we can compute aggregates over a data stream. And also, what about join computation? If we have two streams, we want to join the streams, how can we do that? Because we cannot really wait forever to say that one tuple is finding or not finding a join part in the other stream, right? We cannot do that. And here, the concept of so-called sliding windows come into play. So we're keeping a window over the individual data streams, and these windows somehow bring our data stream into a more like, let's say, snapshot or static relation context. The tuples inside the window are then the ones that are aggregated. And if you have two streams and you have two windows, one for each, then you would compute a join over the tuples in the individual windows. So now this is like bringing us a bit closer to the traditional database context, as opposed to these other considerations earlier about computing count and average queries over data samples and so on. Here we are going a bit more into the area that you know from the database course about SQL queries and so on. So here's an illustration of the sliding window. So we focus usually on the latest value of a stream. So if you're depicting here the time, and then here this is the point in time we're standing, then in this illustration here, this would be our current window describing the data we are currently looking at. And this can then be used to compute aggregates and doing joins. And of course, we do not know the future data coming in next. Here's an example. We have a window of size W. W is a parameter we can set. For instance, based on time, we might want to do monitoring of cars which were passing the street in the last 60 minutes. So then the window, reasonable window, would be 60 minutes. And this is, of course, passing on. We can also do a count-based definition here. Count-based means we are defining how many tuples are to be considered in the window. And in this case here, we have a window consisting of four values, and the window is shifted every so and so many time ticks, or like tuple entries in the case of the count window. Further, so here we have this window is the first one, and then one tuple comes in and the other one come out, and here we are shifting the window always by three, so there's an overlap of one only. This is the second window and the third window and so on. And you see, this depends of course on parameters: how large is the shift, how large is the window, how are you defining the window. So this is not like a precise science that sliding windows are always defined in a certain way, right? This depends on the application and what you want to compute. We will also see later on how we express these sliding windows in our continuous query language CQL. So now when you're doing these windows, you can aggregate. For instance, here we see the average temperature for the individual three windows. That means our output would be a stream as well. For every point in time when the windows are moved, we can output one average value. So the query will continuously output the results. For joins, it's similar. So we have stream one, stream two, we have the window one, window two, and then we can compute the join as we know using hash joins or nested loop joins, depending on the predicates, over the tuples which are included in these windows. I mentioned already briefly there are different types of windows. The time-based window, for instance, you're defining as 10 minutes. You want to monitor Twitter tweets in, or stock markets, maybe then the window would be smaller, maybe 10 seconds if you want to get recent updates on the stock market statistics. The size can change arbitrarily. Also, if the input rate changes, so if you have a window of like 10 minutes and then you have like very many tuples coming in, the windows or the number of tuples you're currently looking at will of course grow arbitrarily depending on the input rate. This is not the case for count-based windows. Here you would fix the amount of items you're looking at, for instance, to 100 tweets or 10,000 stock market trades. And whenever there's new data coming into the system, old data will get eliminated from the window. There are different types, different further types of windows, sliding windows. And this depends here on how you're moving, how you're sliding the window. If you have a sliding window in the natural sense, in the pure sense of sliding, then the window will move, will slide on depending on certain time or tick information. For instance, continuously or in blocks, so larger jumps. Or you have a tumbling window where you're creating a new window for each time range specified by this W parameter. That means these windows are non-overlapping. So it's of course different to the sliding window we have illustrated with the temperature earlier. And whenever you tumble or slide, the query will get evaluated. For instance, the average temperature will be computed and then output. So this will be the data stream generated based on the query over data streams, right? So this will be a stream itself. And this is also why we call it continuous query, because this is like continuously evaluated. There have been various systems proposed in the past that handled data streams, for instance, Stream, by researchers from Stanford University. There are also companies involved in building such systems. And of course, for handling big data streams, we also have some solutions which are operating in a distributed scale-out manner. Here in this lecture, we will specifically talk about Twitter storm. Here's the screenshot of the stream-based UI. So you can basically have some visual support to click your query together by selecting operators and combine these operators like you have seen already from database systems. If you have a query and you're transforming the query into an operator tree, basically here you see how you can combine operators into such a tree. Here, of course, this is modeling a continuous query where the data comes in, the input here, and in the end you're generating output by processing the tuples along these operators, right?